Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to see how we are going to place our column on PCC bed. First you can see this mesh, how these people are doing. First they are going to prepare the mesh by taking the 10mm rods, 10mm in one direction, and another direction also they are going to put 10mm. And if you see the dimension of this mesh, usually they are going to make it square, and some due to some site conditions also we are going to make it rectangular shape, but we referred square shape, because in the both the sides the load is transferring, so we referred square. But based on the site condition, our mesh is little bit irregular shape, because this is the column which is situated under the load bearing structure. So for that we have just measured whatever the groove what we have digged inside the foundation, so that much area only we are just covering this mesh. So in the last video, if you see the part 2 video of my video, so there you can understand how we have done the foundation for this footing. So there, if you, I will just put up that link above, you can click and you can see that video also, the how we have made the groove inside the foundation. So first we have just measured that entire area of the foundation, then we just prepared this mesh. And if you are asking about the center to center spacing of the rods, usually we have taken 6 inches center to center, and most of the most of them they are going to make it for 8 by 8. So here you can see, so this is our PCC bed in the last video what I have shown, and they are just placing it, this PCC bed. So while placing, you can see there the corner of the rods are touching to the ground. So what this person has done, because this whatever the rods which is ending up, that should not touch the ground. Ground means that mud. So for that, what we are going to make, so we are going to make it L shape, right? So why should not touch that ground? Because in future what happens when we do the concreting, if that rod is going to connect with the earth material, so that entire earth material what it does, it going to rust entire earth. So for do the precaution for that, so we going to make it L shape for that, wherever the sharp edges which is touching to the earth material. So you can see he has taken the lever and he has just making up the L shape to the edge of the rods. So you can see this L shape how he is doing. And usually what happens friends, this whatever the lever he is holding, so in the local language in Karnataka, these people used to tell dog. So I just laughed when this people were talking about give me dog. So I was just had fun with that. Okay, and most of the educated person they used to tell this lever, and even the engineer also they going to say the lever. So this lever is meant for to making the rods rising up the L shape. So you can see this, he is making up L. So that is very important friends. So whichever the rod which is touching to the earth, so which will affect in future, because there if the concrete is not packing up, so there what happens, the entire earth going to be rust, and in future the entire whole structure going to be rust, and that entire area will be totally waste. So better you just avoid that sharp edge to connect with the earth material. So I'm just speeding up this video, so you can just see how this work is going. And after putting this mesh, they're going to give the cover. So after giving the cover, on that the mesh going to rest, and you can see this how the column is placed. So before column placing, first we're going to mark where exactly column going to fix, then this column is going to rest on this mesh. So next you can see how this column is placing. So first they're going to prepare this reinforced column, and then they're going to place on this mesh. So you can see this the line, column line, which is drawn on that PCC bed. So exact that location they're going to fix this column reinforcement. So you can just see this how these people are making this column reinforcement, placing on this exactly marked position. So exact projection should be there. So you can see how these people are making. So this has to be take care while placing the column reinforcement. So this is very important to placing up the column. Once you have done with the placing, next you won't disturb. If you disturb this, again entire structure going to be disturbed. So initially, whenever we going to place this column, we have to be so careful so that in future it should not get disturbed. So that is why. So whenever we going to place this, we have to be careful. And you can see this plumb bob how is holding. So they're going to see this plumb bob. So with this plumb bob, we can going to check the verticality of the column. So in the all four sides he has to check, or else you can check only at two sides, that is enough. So after checking, then need to fix this column exact to that position. So for that, they're going to have the temporary structure, and after fixing the column, what they're going to do, so they're going to tie up all the rods, tie up all the wherever the additional L shape they're going to fix with the binding wires. So this L shape rod is having a length of 1.5 feet. So you can see this. So first they're going to make this L properly then they are going to tie up this binding wire with the L-shaped rod to the PCC bed. So he has just given this support, because in the both this side that should not fluctuate the column. So now you can see this concrete we have just mixed for this footing. For our footing we have taken two mesh, one bottom and top. So why we are putting this two mesh for the footing? Because whatever the shear force going to act on the foundation, that can resist twice of that. So whatever the for shear that purpose we are just force going to act on the column. The so that will take double mesh force. So for that we are just taking up so this, the extra precaution.
Two mesh, so this is whatever the mesh distance is there, we have done
is around about 1 feet. 1 feet height. At 1 feet we have so done another one this mesh on that.
Then what we are doing,
we are just footing up column. The concrete thoroughly with the water, and we
for
just
the footing
going to
we have
drag
made
into the foundation. So you can just see how this person is doing. So we are just putting more water and water, and also because that whatever the concrete mix should be there, it going to be a slurry form. So then only we can have the proper mix. So you just see this how this this person is pouring water instantly. You might be thinking more putting water, it's damage the structure. It, that is not the case here, because we have a concrete vibrator at the end of pouring of all entire concrete, then we are going to have our vibrator. So usually for this concrete we have taken 1:3:6 mix. So one bag of cement we have taken 3 bags of sand and 6 bags of coarse aggregate. And usually for the footing we refer 40 mm down size of concrete. Why used to take 40 mm? Because for the footing we are just making up, the volume is more and also the depth is also more. Usually you might be thinking for volume is more means 40 mm only we are going to make use. No, not like that. Depth should also be more. So basically for the footing and for the PCC bed we go for 40 mm down size. If you are thinking for going for 20 mm, that is also not make that much of error, but not a big problem, but you can go for it, no problem. But if you are making use of this 40 mm down size, it may be it gives more strength compared to 20 mm down size of concrete. So that is one thing making up. But if you are going to mix manually like this, so for mixing it will be trouble for mixing up for 40 mm long size. because it requires more strength for mixing up this concrete. And you might be thinking why this footing doesn't have case, because we are just making up this footing on load bearing structure. So at the bottom where we have just screwed, so if you are going to put that case at the end when it's going to set hard concrete, we cannot able to remove that. So what we have done, we have just put all the corners stones, rubber stones, so that whatever the concrete going to pour on it, so which is going to have inset in that area. So in future, if you are thinking of to making this kind of structure, don't hesitate, you can go for it. So whatever the next coming up structures I am going to put in this channel, you can watch it. So you can see this concrete vibrator. You know, concrete vibrator is used for wherever the concrete which is not moving at the corners or which is not compacting. So in that area we are just putting up, you can see the concrete how it is flowing all the corners. So that's all for today's video, friends. In the next video I am going to show the column, how we are going to make the casing and how we are going to pour concrete on that column. Thank you, friends, and if you're having any doubts, please put in the comments below so that I can reply to your doubt. And this is the final product what we have got, and see you in the next video. Thank you and subscribe to my channel. Bye bye, friends.